So we begin executing this instruction. It's a subtraction of 36 minus 3. That's a result is going to be 33. And it takes only one cycle to do adds and subtracts. So this result will be broadcast in cycle 26. So now the next thing that will happen is either this or this will be broadcast. Cycle 26 is the next cycle. So let's see what happens then. In cycle 26, the subtract broadcasts the value of 33 under the name of Rob5. So we mark it as done. 33 gets put here and 33 under the name Rob5 gets broadcast. And this instruction here is waiting for that value. So we get 33 here, are no longer waiting for it. Oh yes, and because this instruction has been dispatched really in cycle 24, in cycle 25 and afterwards, this reservation station has really been free. So this instruction, although it got now 33, still is not ready to dispatch because it's still waiting for Rob1, so it cannot go. Okay, so in cycle 27, nothing happens. 28, nothing happens. In fact, the first time when something does happen from now is going to be cycle 42 when the result of Rob1 is broadcast. So let's just kind of fast forward there. So let's say we are now in cycle 42. This divide finally broadcasts the value of 9 under the name Rob1. What happens is, when that happens, is we put the 9 here, we mark it as done, and the 9 with Rob1 tag is broadcast on the bus, and all the instructions that are waiting for that are gonna capture that value. The only thing that really needs anything is this, and it captures the value of 9, and it's no longer waiting for anything. So in cycle 43, finally this Rob6 instruction is gonna begin execution. So with that, let's move to cycle 43. In cycle 43, we begin execution of this instruction. It's an add of 33 and 9, so we end up with a 42 value here. This reservation station is now free. This is an add, so it's gonna finish in cycle 44. There is another thing that happens in cycle 43, which is all this time we have been waiting to commit this instruction because none of the other ones can commit until it commits. Finally, we have been in cycle 42 to write the result. So in cycle 43, we can actually commit this instruction. It's been marked as done. So pretty much the commit logic is kind of staring at this entry and waiting to see a cycle where this entry has a check mark next to it. So what happens is, finally, we commit this in cycle 43. Now that this instruction commits in 43, what's going to happen is several things. First, the ROB entry for this instruction will be freed. But before we free the ROB entry, we need to update the register file. So what's going to happen is we take this 9 and we're going to write it to register R2. So register R2 is now going to be written as 9. Next, we're going to look at the RAT entry for R2 and see whether it's pointing to our ROB entry. Yes, it is. So from now on, ROB1 will be free after this cycle. What we have to do is make this R2 entry point back to the register file. You know, so the value of 9 that since recently has been basically pointing to, you know, like R2 is here, now it's no longer going to be here, so we need to make it point to R2 is here. I just kind of deleted this, but this really means you can find it in the register file. So now, really, we are ready to delete this stuff here, and now, finally, the divide has fully committed. Okay, so now, if we had an exception or something, basically the divide looks like it's done. All of the other instructions really are done, except for the last one, but they're not considered done as far as the program order is concerned. Basically, the commit didn't get there yet. So now let's move to cycle 44 and see what happens.